was more culturally significant, the Renaissance or Single Ladies by Beyoncé?
They both have their period. They both have their time. Beyoncé I'm rather fond of, but what the Renaissance was trying to do was to reform culture as a whole, and whatever Beyoncé does, I don't think she's quite got that ambition.
So what, the work of a few straight white men just blows Beyoncé out of the water? Is that what you're saying, on camera?
The Egyptians believed the most significant thing you could do in your life was die.
I'm afraid that nuclear war and the threat of nuclear destruction remains very much with us.
Right, can we talk about something a bit more cheerful?
Anything you like.
Do you like ABBA?
I love ABBA.
Britain stands at a fork in its crossroads, and its people are asking questions. Now we've got our country back, what actually is it? Who are we and why? I'm entering a cave, not by mistake or because I'm a wolf, but because I've been specifically asked to come here by the producers to look at cave art. Early cave artists started out painting whatever was close to hand, like their hands. Then they branched out into stories, initially just boring stories about cows standing still.
But soon they began creating white knuckle fight scenes like this. Humans versus cows 2D. To a caveman, this was the thrilling equivalent of Fast and Furious Part 7. Why are pyramids that shape? Is it to stop homeless people sleeping on them?
I don't think they had many homeless people in ancient Egypt.
Oh, did they not?
No, people looked after each other, I think, and helped each other.
Right. I suppose it's good with rain as well, because it'll just roll off. How did Egyptians build the pyramids? Did they start at the top and work down, or start at the bottom and work up?
They had to start at the bottom and work up because it would be impossible to start at the top and work down.